Yes,
Okay.
perfect.
So, very good morning and good afternoon to all. As Prashant already gave a brief about today's topic, like it's all related to the composites and simulating the composite structures using ANSYS solutions. So, because composites are different, fall into a different category in the materials as well, it requires certain different attention to be modeled and to analyze through the FEA solutions. So in today's webinar, what we will do, we will understand first some of the basics about the composites, general introduction to the composites we will see. Then we will just I will divide into the three groups today's presentations, this 1 hour info webinar. Like one is like in general introduction about the composites and what kind of manufacturing process and why it is required during the simulation to be understood while we are simulating it. Then we will see this and certain the introduction to the ANSYS composite pre-post, which is the solution to for the from the ANSYS for the simulating this composite structures. And then we will go for the a small example we will take, and I will just show you how we can just model into the ANSYS composite pre, and then we can take it to the ANSYS solver where you can do different kind of analysis like structural, thermal, or even certain dynamic and explicit analysis, and then the post-processing in ANSYS post. Okay, so with that, I'll not take much time. I'll start with the introduction of the composites. So, as a composite, it is a class of, like, I'll say it's a made up of a different two different materials. One is a matrix and the reinforcement material, and it has its own advantage as it is in a light in weight, having strength, a very high strength. If sometimes we required lightweightening the material. So in that scenarios, the most important the solution is the composites. So composites has its application into wider scenario, I'll say wider industries. It will be it is started in the aerospace, now in wind energy also they are using. And not only these two, but even we can see these sports, motors, motor sports, even some automotive, defense. And now in biomedicals also we are seeing the composites applications. So like if I go with the terminology or the definitions, so composite, I already told, made up of the two different materials. One is called it as a matrix, which is a homogeneous base material that actually forms a bulk of composite material layer. One is the matrix, and we do have one reinforcement fibers which is bonded and embedded into the matrix. So with respect to different orientations, and this is the fibers are the responsible for the anisotropy of the composites. So there are one is matrix, another is a fiber. Then a composite material in a sheet form, we called it as a lamina or a layer or a ply. Okay, the material properties are usually determined through the homogenization or smearing process here. And once we have the lamina, the stack of lamina, we can join with respect to certain joining or manufacturing process with arbitrary directions. So we call it as a laminate or a composite layup or a stacking or a sequence. So in most of the time, we call it as a composite layup. So like once we have a lamina, this lamina or a layer, one layer do we have with respect to different fiber orientations. Like if I say this is the 90 degree fiber orientations, then there is a plus minus certain angles we have a fiber orientations and 0 degree fiber orientations. Then what we can do with respect to certain process, we called it as a laminating. Like we have certain manufacturing process like hand layup or even a filament winding, pultrusion, resin transfer molding, RTM process. With respect to that, we can create certain these laminates. and this is called as a lamina. This is laminating process, and we will come up with the laminate, which is called a stacking sequence. Now there are a classification of the composites basically onto the reinforcement. So we have a short and long fiber composites. So when we particle reinforcement composites, like there are short particles are embedded into the matrix, we called it as a particle reinforced composite or a short fiber composites. And we also have a fiber reinforcement composite. These are particle reinforcement composites. Then in the fiber reinforcement, we have short fiber and long fiber. Like a short fiber in the sense we can go for the very short fiber, which are going to be embedded into the plus this matrix. And then we have a long fiber reinforcements. Even so, like in ANSYS composite pre, we basically simulate the long fiber reinforcement, and the short fiber reinforcements, like these are treated indifferent because their manufacturing, like we do have certain mold flow process where we can get certain short fiber composite orientations, and it requires different attention to be for while doing the simulation. Now what kind of matrix materials basically we deals with, like there are certain thermoset, thermoplastic, metals and ceramics are there. Similarly, fibers are in like glass fibers, carbons, we do have Kevlars, boron and ceramics. This is the sum of the list. We do have other matrix and fiber materials as well. Then there are manufacturing processes also important, how we are going to manufacture that composite component after having one layer, or we have a lamina. So there are two, like one is called open molding, where the process this process is going to be we do this is into the open atmospheric, so all the materials are exposed to the atmosphere during the manufacturing process. And we do have a closed molding, where we have a controlled environment. All the components, all the materials are into the controlled environments while manufacturing process. We do manufacturing process. So depending upon that's open and closed, we do have like open molding. We have a hand layup, spray up, and filament windings, which are the open moldings. And these are important. Why? Because like whenever we are having some hand layup or spray layup or even a filament winding, so the while modeling into the ANSYS, or when we are modeling into the ANSYS, or once we want to analyze that structures, so we need to understand the manufacturing process, and depending upon that, like if that is a filament wind, so like the most of the cylinders we are composite cylinders we manufacture through filament windings, so that windings orientations and everything is required. So it also depends upon what manufacturing process and what we are going to be do. Then in the closed molding, there are common processes like pultrusion, resin transfer molding, then compression molding. So these are important, and sometimes this process itself creates certain residual stresses, or sometimes we want to in a pultrusion or resin transfer molding, we want to understand the curing process. So that is also possible into the ANSYS simulation. We can simulate the curing process as well. This is just to understand or give us a feel about the size. Like this is the rotor of a wind turbine, and you can see the rotor diameter is very large. Even the height, hub height is like almost 100 meters, and we have embedded certain reinforcement fibers into it, which are very small in the direct dimensions. So we have to model this such kind of a large scale model into the ANSYS. So to do this kind of analysis through the numerical approaches, we do have a different there are three process through numerical approaches which we can solve this composite. We can analyze the composite structure. One is like micro scale approach, one is meso scale approach, and other is macro scale approach. So micro scale approach is very detailed one approach, I will say, where we actually go for the detailed modeling of the composites, which includes the fiber shape, fiber locations, fiber fractions, and the material properties of the reinforcement and matrix. We will take it very detailed way. And there are other approach. We call it as a micro scale approach. Once where we only want like a displacement or the buckling loads, or we want certain dynamic response. We are doing certain linear dynamic analysis. So in these scenarios, we go with the macro scale approach, where where the laminates which we have created, we will analyze it as a homogeneous shell. So here we just want as a mass in a linear dynamics. So we don't want to go in detail about any other structural or stresses in that individual layers. So here we will analyze through homogenization process, and we will do the analysis. So stress distributions cannot be obtained here. Okay, so these are the two options. One is micro scale and the macro scale approach, and there is another approach. We called it as a mesoscale, where we want to understand the stresses, strain, failure criteria of the composite layers onto the single layer. So this is on the single layer we want to understand the results. So this is the when we create a ply, one ply we will create into the analysis, and we apply certain thicknesses to that ply, and even we can stack that multiple plies together. So basically, what are the material properties required here in numerical? This mesoscale approach is on the properties of that each layer, and each layer thickness we obtained here in modeling. So ANSYS SCP, which is composite pre and post, is mainly used this mesoscale approach to prepare and evaluate the composite for the specific design. So ANSYS, the simulation solution, will use the mesoscale approach to analyze the composites. So while like we are going to do the modeling or to understand the composites, we should know certain basic fundamentals about this material characteristics. So one is about the coordinate system. So what kind of coordinate system we are going to use? So there are one direction, two direction, there are three directions. So which we represent by first direction, second direction, and third direction. Also, we called it as a first direction as a parallel to the fiber directions. So this is the first direction, which is the parallel to the fiber directions. And the second direction is the perpendicular to the fiber, which is the second direction, and the third direction is the out of plane direction. We called it as a z directions as well. So it is a actually normal to the that ply. So in the ANSYS technology, like most of the composites are in the shell, are the shells which are having a thin, which are having a very small in thickness compared to the other two directions. So like in ANSYS, we start the modeling with the shell element itself. So we do have certain shell elements, like a four node structural shell, which is shell 181, or we do have a quadratic shells as well, which is 281. So even we have certain triangular options as well, which is like a linear and non-linear triangular, which is that also we can sometimes switch with, but which is not recommended. So in this structural shell, we required, when we can go with the layer structure elements. So elements are required the mechanical material properties in the all the three directions, as it's orthotropic in the nature. So X modulus in XYZ, shear modulus in XY and YZ, all the three planes, and similarly Poisson's ratio in all the three planes. So this is the material properties minimum required. But when we go for the certain failure criteria, which are specific for the composites, like Hashim or Tsiu, so that also requires certain failure criteria constants, depending upon which failure criteria you are going to use for the analysis. Also, we can not only it is not like that only we can go with the shell, but we start our modeling process with shell itself, but we can create a solid element as well. So it's a basically a solid extrusion. We will create the shell elements and we extrude to the solids with solid 185 or solid 186 element, which are available in the ANSYS. Similarly, we also have some solid like shell elements who are already working in the ANSYS. They might have aware about this element, which is the solid shell elements, solid shell 190 elements. Then like this is about the inputs which we require. Then what kind of failure indicators we can get through this is like we can get the first ply failure. Okay, so this is the mathematical equation which indicates our the first failure of any ply. Similarly, we can get where that failure is going to occur, either into the fiber tension, fiber compression, or what failure mode it is actually failing, whether the fiber is failing or the matrix is failing. Also, we can get certain specific outputs like a reserve factor, inverse reserve factor, and margin of safety, which are imported in the composite domain. And like it's a composite, so we do have a maximum stress and maximum strain failure criteria, which are general criteria, but dedicatedly all the other advanced failure criteria like TSIU, TSI-HEAL, even Kunze, we can do this kind of failure criteria, we can analyze. Also, like it is not just like a first fly failure, but if we can go for the progressive damage as well, we can go for last fly failure. So basically, it's if we increase the loading beyond the first fly failure until the ultimate failure of the laminate, so we can do that as well. So we can do that as well. So basically, this is the basic introduction what I will say about the composites. Like what kind of composites treatment we required, like how the failure we can go for first and last ply failure as well. So now we will see how we can do it into the ANSYS composite pre post. Okay, so ANSYS composite pre post, this is the composite design cycle. I will brief you this in short first so that we can understand. Like we do have like our own mold surface here, so we can take that mold surface, we can assign certain loads and boundary conditions and materials, everything here, but here we can create some like if suppose this is a metallic, we can directly apply such isotropic mean measure, we can directly apply the board loads and boundary conditions on the CAD. But what into the composites, we have to start with the layer wise, we have to model each and everything. So so we can create this stack up, start with homogeneous stack up, we can do certain analysis, and if fails under certain loading conditions, we can do certain local reinforcements or layer modification also we can do, and we can share the mold surface final geometry. So what we can do under a composite pre-post, so there are two things. One is composite pre and composite post. So composite pre will do all the pre-processing, and composite post will do the all the post-processing things. So into the composite pre, we can design the composites as a shell or solid. We can define the ply-wise complex composite layer, different plies we can create. We can define the fiber directions and its orientations. So fiber directions are not necessary. It should be like a parallel or perpendicular to that matrix itself. It can be like 45 degrees or 30 degrees, which can incline. So we can control over the fiber directions. We can modify or optimize the composite design. Say suppose if you want to increase the number of layers, certain at certain location, the composites are going, the structure is going to be failed. So we can create a patch over there. So local reinforcements also we can do, and then we can analyze the composite design parameters, and we can generate certain manufacturing information as well, which is required to do the manufacturing, which might be like a layer of information through in Excel. So also we can export and we can save that things. Then in post, we can evaluate the composite design by means of the composite failure criteria. We can go for fiber and sandwich failure modes, even reserve this which are the safety factor, margin of safety, inverse reserve factor. These things we can evaluate stresses and strain in each layer. There are multiple layers are there, so each layer we can get for these stresses and stress. We also can get the critical layer information, which layer is going to be fail and which loading there are. If suppose there are multiple loadings are there, and which whether it is going to fail into the tensile or compression or this kind of things also we can go. And if there is a multiple loadings are there, we can understand the which is the critical load condition for this particular composites. So this is in the ANSYS how we can start. So it is a fully integrated into the ANSYS workbench. No need to go for any other tool. Everything you can do in the ANSYS environment, that ANSYS workbench platform itself. So in post, like you can take any of this surface from the any of your CAD modeler tool to directly to the spec claim, or even you can create your surfaces into the that mold surfaces into the spec claim itself. And then you can assign the materials, you can do certain meshing, you can do the meshing, you can create the composite layout into the SCP pre, and you can transfer this into the one analysis where you can want to do any static structure analysis or any linear dynamic analysis you want to do. In this analysis, you can create the loads and boundary condition, okay? And even you can do certain mechanical post-processing. So in ANSYS mechanical itself, we can do certain post-processing. But if you want to go for detailed post-processing, you can go for the SCP post-processing, where you can go for the ply-wise stresses, strain, and even each thing you can get. So this is the wider ANSYS composite ecosystem. Just to understand, give you the brief. It's not only just we are going to solve it. We can check the strength itself, but certain manufacturing process also we can simulate into the ANSYS ecosystem. So in ANSYS ecosystem, if I say this is ANSYS pre, here the material is most important thing. So ANSYS has its material solutions like a Granta MDS, where Granta solutions where we have already material properties for some common or I'll say some of the materials with respect to certain standards. Also, we have a material designer where you can create your own material properties for the composites. It's basically a homogenization method. We create one representative volume element. We can give the fiber orientations, fiber fractions, and the isotropic material properties for the matrix and the reinforcement fiber. And then we can create with respect to certain numerical approach, the homogenization process, you can get the orthotopic properties for that particular composites. So you can create a representative volume element for a different kind of composites. It might be like a unidirectional or woven composites, or even this ANSYS material designer can be support. You can go for the short fiber composites as well. So it's very good to start with a material designer as well if you do not have any material property available with you. Even you can import certain third party application mesh directly to the ANSYS. Then even some of the companies or some of the engineers, they do their composites definition through Excel as well, and they also do use certain CAD modeler tool. So you can import from the Excel and the third party application that composite definition directly if you already created. Then you can take as an output as a STP or IGS when once you have created the or you have prepared the composite layup, so that you can export for further requirement for the manufacturings like a CAD. You can give the ply boundaries or flat wrap, you can export and you can use that for your future reference. And even you can third party application composite definitions in the some of the H5 extensions, you can export that things also. Now once you have created the pre-processing, you can do the multiple analysis. So here are click analysis, and these some of the manufacturing processes. You can do the structural thermal analysis. You can do the composite curing process through our ANSYS composite curing simulations. So it's like your manufacturing process. You can simulate here. You can get the distortions occur during the manufacturing processes, or you can go for the fluent. So just to see the how the do certain fluent analysis, and you can go for the dynamics as well, as we have discussed already. So this you can do for a solid and cell both, and you can do for certain explicit analysis also. It now LSDAN is a part of ANSYS, and you can export this to a .k file where you can do certain pre and post processing, or you can solve under the LSDyna, and then you can do certain post processing things. So this is the wider composite ecosystem, I will say. And then we do have like ACP uses, how we can go with the ANSYS composites. Like, there is a material first, we have to define the material depending upon what kind of analysis. So minimum like mechanical properties we have to assign with respect to three different directions. And depending upon how much complexity we are going to do, like if we do have certain advanced composite criteria, failure criteria we have to assess, then you can you have to add that constants, additional constants to it. And if suppose we do have like composite curing process you want to simulate, so that related to the that we have to add certain material properties. Then you can create the layup, like fiber directions you can define, you can create the rosettes, you can create the orientations. So different fiber layup, we can this layup you can create here, and then you can do the model review where whether you have created that is corrected or not. We can create certain section cuts where you can see the thickness direction, how the composites have created. Even you can create certain polar properties plot as well. So where you can see the polar plots of your material properties and how the material properties are changing with respect to the that particular layer or that thickness directions. Or you can create the sampling as well for in the post processing. So here you can do the post processing for a simple stresses, deflection, deformations, or even with respect to the different failures, which failure it is going to be occur. And even you can get the critical layer, critical load step values, everything you can get into the post processing. So this is the four key steps while you are going to use the ANSYS ACP. And I will explain this through one of the example, so you'll get to know more detail about it. So why ANSYS is most easiest tool to model the composite? It's because the philosophy which ANSYS has, it's like a model as you built it. So how you are going to build it into your workshop, you use the same method or same process in modeling in ANSYS as well, like a ply on ply methodology. Which we are going to use in the workshop. Similarly, we are going to create these stackups here into the ANSYS model. So this is the ply-based modeling, which is very easy, which is ANSYS going to be used. And there is a conventional, old zone-based modeling is also there. So we have to create a different zones we have to create. And this is actually, it will take too much time because you have to create the different zones. We have to define, subdivide the geometries. You have to specify individual laminate for each layer. And it will take some time, but with respect to this ply-based methodology, we can do very easily. We can model the composites. So in like a model as you built it, approach it like a mold surface you do have. You will create one ply. You will apply the ply on ply onto these molds, and you will get the resultant layup here. Even you can basically we will mimic this manufacturing process, actual manufacturing process. Similarly, if this is a if you have any other different manufacturing process, we can mimic that as well. This is the workflow like ANSYS pre-post. Then we will take that information to the static structure. We apply loading condition, bounding conditions, that constraints, and then we will do the post processing. So in the material data, which is most important thing, so we can apply the material properties for that. We can create our own material property, or we can get the from ANSYS some of the basic material also. Standard material also is having in ANSYS library, or you can go use of the ANSYS Granta MDS, where the material data for simulations already we do have certain material properties there. You can use directly, or you can create your own material properties material here, which you can apply the material. So where you can check with the regular ply, woven ply. So with all kind of plies are also there here, and you can add the orthotopic elasticity here. It just drag and drop things are there. And even when we go for the failure criteria, we have the T-psi-U constant, Puck constants, all this LARC, this all advanced failure criteria are also available. Just you have to drag and drop, and you have to add the constants which are required to do that kind of analysis. And there are different ply type are available to define the ply. Now the mesh generation, as I assume like you are aware some of things, basic things about the ANSYS as well. We will start with the meshing with always with the shell mesh here in the ANSYS, and then whenever we want to go for the solid, like when we want to model as a solid, so it will be just extrusion of this shell mesh while we are going to be connected to the any static structural analysis. And we will create the composite layup here. So what I will do, as an interest of time, instead of going through these presentations, I will directly show you how we are going to on the software itself. So first, this is the most important thing. This is the three-step composite layup creation. One is the material data. We will create the material layer thickness here in a composite material definition we'll define. Then we will create the orientation selection set, which is important. Why? Because layup area, layup orientations, and the reference directions, like this is the layup area, which area we want to layup that composites. Then the orientations, which direction, because we do have the surface, so both the directions we can which direction we want to orient that layup, we can define that orientation, and the reference direction. Now my fibers, how that is going to be run in, what is the reference direction for my fiber, that is also important. And then we will create the layup. So for doing this, we take the help of the rosettes in the ANSYS. So what I will do, instead of going through the presentation as an interest of time, I'll show you these things on the onto the ANSYS software itself. So this is the ANSYS workbench platform, under which we do have a different analysis setting and component systems are available. So what I did, I imported one specific geometry, like a T, like a structure. So I will just show you one thing about the this. So this example is basically about the selling bolt. There are different kind of T joints are there. So this kind of T joints we have to model as an composites. So if I show you the layup information here, so there are different layups are available. Like there are a base plate which is made up of like first six layers are there with certain composites, unidirectional composites, and then 10 mm honeycomb structures are there. And then again there are six layers of unidirectional composite materials is there with respect to, these are the 90 0 and 45 45. This this defines the fiber direction for that particular layer. So 90 degrees one layer, 0 45 45 90 0, these are the layers. Then this is the base plate. Then there is a stringer which is having the five like almost 10 10 layers of like 0 90 fibers with 0.1 mm unidirectional. And then there is a bonding. There are left and right side, both bondings are available. And then after last, there is one cover which will having the four layers with 0.1 mm unidirectional composites. Okay, so this we are going to take on this an example. So if I show you, this is the T joint in a space claim. I do have all these four surfaces available here. So now what I will do, I'll directly go to the ANSYS pre. So what I'll show you just one thing, like if I go with the geometry, if I took the geometry, I can import one geometry, and then here we do have ANSYS composite pre and post. So directly I can drop here. So the geometry is going to be shared here. So now if I open the model, which is into the mechanical, we require certain name selections to be done, because these name selections will come in ANSYS pre as a element set, where we can use that element set to create the layers at that particular locations. So now if you see, these are the geometry part one, part two. So before going to the geometry, I just forgot to mention about the engineering data. Okay, so now we do have I have taken the epoxy carbon unidirectional, which is 395 gigapascal prepack. So I have created the material properties for this. If you see the all orthotropic thermal as well as the elastic mechanical properties are there, Young's modulus in XYZ directions and Poisson's and shear modulus in that particular all the three planes. Even I have added all the failure criterias like a stress limit, strain limit, and even T psi over Puck constants. So these constants are required to when we are going to for this particular failure criterias. We can add any multiple composite different things we can add here. There are all the failure criterias are available. Similarly, at the ply type, it's a regular ply type. There are different ply types are available, like one isotropic, adhesive, or honeycomb structure. So regular ply I'm using. Okay, and similarly, there is another honeycomb structure, that is the this the core is made up of the 10 mm honeycomb core is there. So for that purpose also, we have added one honeycomb core material properties, and for this the ply type is the honeycomb core. So now what we will do, like into the mechanical, like right now we are applying here, you can who already worked in the mechanical, they might have aware, like we assign the material properties here as well. So right now we are not going to apply directly here material. Here it is assigned as a honeycomb, so which we are going to change into the SCP afterwards. Now the mesh, I just did the meshing here, and the dummy thickness is defined for all the surfaces like 1 mm, but eventually we will change these thicknesses because we are going to model these things into the ANSYS pre-post. So now all the meshing controls we have applied, and we do I did certain name selection. This is a plate 1, plate 2, plate 3, plate 4, and similarly joint 1 and joint 2 I have created. Okay, so this joint 1 and joint 2. So this name selections we have to create, and meshing we have to do initial mesh, this surface mesh we have to do. So I'll not explain detail about the meshing. I understood most of you aware about the meshing and this name selection creation in the ANSYS workbench. Now what we can go, we can directly go to the setup now. So once we have click onto the setup, the ACP ANSYS composite pre will going to be open. So this is the user interface of the ANSYS composite pre, where we do have a left side, all the information about the material data, element sets, everything is there, lookup table, row sets, orientation selection set. This is the window where we are going to work, and these are the some of the tools which are important here. Like we will show the elements here. These are the elements we are going to see, and these are the certain orientations, or I'll say certain things are there which we require to show the reference directions or fiber directions, fiber orientations, or in transverse directions. We can see through these representations from here. So I'll start with this. Like if you see whatever material you have added into the engineering data, it will come directly here. I will just update these materials. So all the material properties also you can see here. Okay, you can check with the other comp, but you cannot edit these things. You have to edit into the engineering data itself, but you can check what material properties you have given. Okay, then the first important thing is to create the fabric, which the layer basically we are going to create. So what I will do, into the our these things all are like 0.1 mm thickness unidirectional composites layers are there with respect to different fiber orientations. So I will create one fabric of composite prepack. I will name it as a composite prepack epoxy carbon unidirectional as this fabric. I will give the thickness as a 0.1 mm, and I will apply OK So it's created one fabric. Similarly, for the core also, I have to create one more fabric. So I will check, get the these things, honeycomb thing as a material. I'll apply the 10 mm as a thickness, as a honeycomb is a 10 mm in thick. Then I'll apply okay, or I can just update these things here. So now I have created two fabrics. So now the most important thing here is like how we are going to create the layers, because if you see some of the layers, like base layers are completely on horizontal, but there are certain layers which are up to the only certain locations, like this. If you see this bondings are like L type shape, it is not over complete things, and the base plate is also for on horizontal and it's in downward direction, and stringers are only on to the left side or right side of these things with the vertical plate. So you have to control all these things, and for this we have to take the help of the orientation selection set. Before that, there is a one term called the rosettes. So rosettes will define the direction of the fibers. This is the fiber direction it will define. So I'll create one rosette here. So to create the fiber direction rosette, what we have to do, we have to select one origin. I'll select one origin here, as I'll select one of the element. Okay, so now if you see, I selected element, it will show certain fiber directions to us. Okay, so now what I will do, I'll create one orientation selection set for this as an fiber directions. If you see, the fiber direction should be like this to this side. So this red X direction will show us the fiber direction, and the transverse direction also, if you want to select, you just select one node here and press Control and another node. So now if you see, this is the one rosette we have created. If you want to flip, you can flip here. But what I want, the element, the fiber direction should be in this direction. This is red is X, green is Y, and Z is the purple is the Z direction. So this is my fiber direction. This is my transfer to the fiber direction, and this is outer plane fiber direction. If I apply these things, okay, you can see here X, Y, and Z components, Z directions are created for this particular rosettes. So this one rosette I have created. With respect to that one rosette, now I will create one orientation selection set. So I will create one orientation selection set. I will name it as like a base, like OSS base. Okay, so now I have to select, like I'll just put this as a cancel. If you see the element set, whatever name selections we have created, like all elements are there one, but whatever the name selections we have created, that came as a one element set here. If you can see, this is in the green region. This is joined to plate 1, plate 2, plate 3, plate 4. Okay, so now all this came as a element set, and we will use this element set as the to create the orientation selection set. So what orientation selection set, I told you these are three different thing into the orientation selection. See, this most important thing is the layup area where we are going to layup that thing, and then the orientation is defined by rosette, layup area is defined by this element sets, and the reference direction reference direction is defined by the rosettes, and orientation we have to define through OSS only, that oriented selection set. I will show you how the orientation we can select. So now for the base, I have to select all the elements which are onto the base plate. So what I will do, I'll go to the orientation selection set. I'll give the name as a base OSS underscore base, so that I can understand which orientation selection set it is. I'll select the this plate 1, plate 2, plate 3, plate 4. Okay, so now you can see here all horizontal plates I have selected these things as an element set. Then this is the orientation where you want your orientation to be. Like now, right now, the orientation I want as a downward. Okay, so what I can do, like I can select any, I can go to this, the point I'll select here, and automatically it is down pointed downward. I want downward only. But once, if you want upward, so you can flip that things, very simple. Right now I want onto the downside only, so I'm doing that one. So now I want to select the rosettes. Rosette to just understand the fiber direction, which fiber direction. So what I will do, I have created one rosette. I'll select this rosette. So this is the fiber direction which I have created. Now I'll apply this thing. Okay, so now this orientation selection set I have created. In this, once I have created the orientation selection set, now I will create the apply. So modeling apply group, I will name it as a base. One group I will create, and then with respect to that, I will create one apply. Okay, so this apply orientation selection set is base, which I have selected. The apply material is my carbon epoxy unidirectional. The apply angle is zero right now. What I will do, I'll just do okay and apply. So I'll just update this thing. I'll show you. You can see here. Now this yellow is my fiber direction, and downward is my pink color is my orientation, which is in downward. So this is the one layer I have created. So what I will do, there are six layers basically with respect to different orientations. So I with respect to different angles, you can see 0 90 0 45, like this. So what I will do, I'll just duplicate, I'll just copy this one, and I'll paste after. I'll do paste after for another 5 times. Okay, so now I have created the six plies, but now you can see here the ply angle is zero for everyone. So you can go and you can edit ply angle for each layer here. You can go for and you can edit as a like whatever, be like it's 90 at the first layer. So I can go and ply angle, I can give as a 90, or there is a very easy way. What I can go, I can just select the, this is the Excel. We can use the Excel entity here, the modeling group, all instead of all, I'll select this base which I have created, and I will open the Excel sheet. So what it will do, it will open the one Excel sheet. Sorry, I have not selected anything. I'll do all right now, like open Excel sheet. Now it will show open Excel sheet. All the six layers which we have created, everything is defined here. You can see ply number and everything, all information. So what I can do, I will easily do here the angle, like minus 45 now. Oh, sorry, I'll check once again. It's okay, plus 45, then minus 45, 90 and 0. Now 45, minus 45 for third layer, then this is a 90 and 0 degree. So now once we have created this, you what we can go once again, and here is the option called pull from. So automatically it will pull from that things and will close all these things. Okay, now I will update these things. I'll check randomly one. So you can see ply angle is minus 45 automatically, and you can see how that ply is defined here. So now this green represents my fiber directions here. Yellow represent my reference direction. This is my zero direction, reference direction. This green represent my fiber direction, which is 45 degree angle, and this is my orientation. Okay, so now I have created all these things as a base. First layer I have created. Similarly, I have to create one honeycomb core before that. So what I will do, I will just create one ply after. Okay, this thing. So what I can go, I'll select the orientation selection set again. Similarly, this ply material honeycomb structure, ply angle that is zero right now. So in the thickness, what I will do, these things here in the thickness, I will go for the tapering, and I will select the tapering. This thing where I did one here tapering. Okay, apply. So I will update this thing. So now as we are not able to see whether that is created or not, like all the plies are created or not, we are not able to see just this thing. So we can do one cut section, and we can understand whether that is created or not. So we can go for the section cut. We can create the section cut at this location here. So what I can do, I can just scale here. I can scale the my layup with respect to 10 and my core with 0.1, because core thickness is 10 mm. So it should be reasonably, we can see here. So here you can see, okay, just one thing. I did for the thickness, tapering angle is 20. Apply. Okay. So what happened? It is not.
taking the tapering. Okay, sorry, I have to update this as well. Okay, now you can see there is a tapering also for this. We have applied this tapering and this is the core now. So now each layer you can see there is one layer, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth layer, and this is my core, which is 10 mm in the thickness. So similarly, what I can do, I can create one again the ply. After I can create one more ply, which is for the I have created one more, which is up for the eighth layer. Similarly, I can copy this, copy, and I will paste again this for six times, or you can select multiple these two and you can paste after. And then you can, how many we have created? 8, 9, 10. I'll select this all three, copy, I'll paste after. So all the six we have created now. So again, I can go to the this Excel sheet. Open Excel sheet. Sorry. Okay. Now all the layers are available here. Now what? This is the honeycomb structures. Now I will apply my orientation selection set like a 0, 90, which are plus 45. Plus 45. This is minus 45. This is again 0 and 90. Okay. Now we will go again, pull from. Close, so it will create all the layers with respect to that. So we have created this layer, you can see here in section cut, all the layers are created on the base. Now the next thing is about on the bonding. So now we have to go for the bonding here similarly. So I'll show for the bonding one left and right. So again, you will go for the rosette, create the rosette one more time. So this is rosette for now, where we are going to create the bonding here. Okay, so I'll select this one of the, again, same information here. We have to select once again. Okay, now this is my fiber directions we have to define. So fiber direction is from this to this. Okay, now. And my. This second direction should be from this to this. Okay, so this is the second rosette we have created. Apply. Okay, now if you see, this is the second rosette we have created. Now we have to create some bondings on the left and right. Stringers we have to create first on the left. So for the stringers, this is my fiber orientations. So I'll go to the again orientation selection set. I'll select this is OSS for the stringer. Okay, and I'll select all the stringers element set, which are nothing but the joint one and joint two. Okay, the point of orientations will be on the other direction. So in this direction on the right side, we have to create that stringers. So what I will do, I'll select one of the point here, and I'll just flip the direction. So it is in this other directions, and the rosette for this is the second rosette. Okay, apply. So I'll just create this update. So this orientation selection set I have created. Similarly, in modeling ply, I'll create one more modeling ply, which is for the stringer. Okay, so in the stringers, we have how many layers? We have 10 layers of 090 in these directions. So what I will do, I'll create one ply. Okay, I will select the orientation selection set as the stringer. Material as the epoxy carbon with respect to zero. Basically, we want it as a 0 and 90 degrees. So I will put it as a 0. Okay, number of ply, and we'll apply one thing. Okay, so if you see this ply, ply direction, I'll show you the orientations. This fiber orientation is about 90, and our reference direction is this. Okay, so now what I will do. I'll create one more. I'll duplicate this copy and the paste after. So now the changes here is 90 degree. Okay, apply. Okay. Okay, now similarly we will copy this And how many layers do we have? It's like a 10 layers, 5 multiplied by these 2. So I'll paste another 4 times. Okay, so now all the 10 layers we have created. I'll go to the again Excel. So now instead of going for all, I will just take these strangers only, open Excel sheet. So only stranger layers will come here, not all the layers which we have created for the layers. So automatically it's a 090, 090, it is there already. So already we can pull from this and we can just update these things. Okay, so now the most important thing you can see here, the strangers are also came here. Now after the strangers, we do have the bonding at left side, but all for the bonding, it is on the from the just this joint 1 and this plate 3. Up to that level only we do have the and the orientations are also different for this. So if you see the orientation for the bondings are like 45 and minus 45, 8 layers are there with respect to 45 and minus 45. So here we have to take we have to be sure that we have to create a two different row sets now here, and we have to use the combination of that row sets. So I'll go once again, I'll create one more row set for this. I'll select this as an input layer here, then as an direction, what I will do, I'll select this as a direction 1. And my second direction will be this, and this is my second direction, and my downward direction is the third. Okay, so I have created one more row set here. Now I'll just update for this row set. Now I will create the orientation selection set for this OSS for bonding left. Okay, now element set, I will choose, this is the joint 1, control plate 3. This is my element sets. You can see the green location. Then the point I have to select one here to just to understand the orientation. So orientation is I want above here. Now you can see the fiber direction for this horizontal plate is in this direction, and the vertical is above direction, vertical, which is like this x direction, and this is x direction for this. So for this, we have to use the combination of the row sets. We have to use two row sets which we have created at the first second and the third. So I'll select the second and the third because the orientation for this one and above is this, and there is an option called selection method, minimum angle, maximum angle. I'll tell you that thing. Once I click OK, I have created one orientation selection set. Something happened. Why? Because that not created properly. So what I can do, I can just change it to the maximum angle. Okay, and I'll update these things. I'll tell you how the fiber direction or this reference direction is taken care with respect to the orientation selection set. So if you see the fiber direction, it has taken the fiber direction of this row set, and for this it is taken as this row set. So it depends upon the what selections method we are using, as a maximum angle, minimum angle, or what. So when you see the orientation, is like, if our orientation is above, like I'll say, show you this orientation, but this orientation is this pink thing. The angle between the orientation and out of these two rosettes, which is maximum, that angle it will take, that rosette it will take automatically. Say suppose for this plate we have chosen maximum, so this rosette, this pink direction, this is the orientation, and out of these two rosettes with respect to the fiber direction, which is x direction for the rosette, which is the maximum, if that is the maximum, that rosette it will take. So now this is the fiber orientation. With respect to this rosette, it is a 90 degree. With respect to this rosette, it is a 0 degree. So maximum is 90. Maximum is 90 here. So it will take automatically the reference direction with respect to these rosettes. Similarly here, if you see the orientation is this side, And this, with respect to this rosette, it's a 90 degree, and with respect to this rosette, it's a zero. So automatically it chooses this rosette we have to choose. If you go with the minimum angle, so what it will do, it will check the minimum angle, and which is the minimum angle, it will apply on that side. Okay, so this is the way the rosette, with multiple rosettes are there, we will understand the rosettes. So as an interest of time, I will just create a left bonding left, and I will tell you how other things as well. Okay, apply. I'll create the ply one. So I'll select the orientation selection for the bonding. Material ply is this. The angle is 45. Apply. Okay, so you can see now, I'll just orientation. So now you can see this is the fiber orientation is 45 with respect to my reference directions. And here also is fiber orientation is 45. So this is the one layer we have created. So I'll just copy this layer, I'll paste after, and I'll generate this thing. So this I'll copy. We have to create 8. Okay, now I'll go to the Excel sheet. Not all, I'll go with the bonding left, open Excel. So layers are like 45 minus 45 all. So 45, this is minus 45, this is minus 45, this is minus 45, this is minus 45. Okay, now we will pull from, apply. Okay, close all, and we have created all the layers. If you see how you are going to see here, like these are the bondings. All the 8 layers are created here. Similarly, we can create on the right side and the right side as well as the, we can replicate these things on the right side as well. And similarly, we can create for the cover. So as an interest of time, what I will do, I have solved one model. I'll just show you on that location. And we can, then we can go for the question answers if you have any. Okay, so now here I have already created like modeling groups, modeling right, left, cover also I have created. So what I will do, I'll just update this section. So everything is, I will update first. So if you see here, I will lay up, I will hide this. Okay, first, so if you see, similarly I have created the left, left as well, and then on the left we have created the cover, which is again, cover is made up of these four layers, 45 minus 45, 0 and 90. We have created that four layers as well here into the cover. If you see one of the ply, which is of minus 45. Okay, so this ply and its orientation you can see here directly. Okay, and this way we can directly model. Now we can check the thickness angle as well. Like I can just show, I can made this as a show, where you can understand the angle. Basically this is angle plot we have created here. So you can see this red is nothing but the 90 degree ply is there, and whenever the green is there, this is the zero degree layer, and whenever we have a like orange, these are like a 45 degree angle fiber orientation, this thing is there. So once we have created this, what we have to do, like if I just update this thing, the half section itself, what you have to do, you have to go for the static structure analysis. I will show you here. You have to connect with the static structure analysis, and we have to apply the boundary condition, and then we go for the post processing. I'll just show you the workflow. It is taking some time to update. So what we have to do, say suppose there is a ACP pre here, then we will go for the static structure analysis, and from this setup to this model we can apply, and then it will ask for the solid composite data or shell composite data. Already we have modeled as a shell, but we can transfer through solid also, it will extrude that thing directly. If I just click onto the shell, it will create, it will transfer only the shell data directly to the here. And then we can go for the post, we can drop to the model, and all these solutions we can model through the results. So now it is connected to the post. So this way you can directly do the post processing as well. Okay, so now I will open, I have created everything. You can see already everything is created here. You can see the elements as well here. Now I will open it into the mechanical, and I'll show you how it's going to look like here. Okay, so here if you see all the layers right now, I will, if you see what it comes, all the geometry, both the geometry materials, and then you have imported plies. So with respect to base, all the base plate plies, this is the stringer plies, all the bonding left, these all plies are here. If you click on any of ply, you will see the, this is the ply at that location, and the detail of that ply is written here. The thickness, the angle, everything you can see here. Now, if you click onto the mesh, you will see the mesh. You can visualize with respect to this thick cross section, so you will understood. Now you can see here, this is the thickness at less, but here we have some bonding plates are here. So this way you can see the, but it's a layer wise structure. Now what you can do directly as a whatever we do into the structure analysis, you can just apply the fixed support, you apply the force, you just solve that one, and you can do the solutions, and you can see the total deformation plot, equivalent stress or anything here as well, or you can directly couple it to the here into the our post processing. You go to results. I have shown how to connect this post processing things. And once we are here in this is the ACP post thing. If you see, everything will come here similarly like our ACP pre, and the additional thing we have here is like a solution. So already we one solution we have here. So what I will do, I'll just update this solution. Okay. Then in the definition, we can create certain definition, create a failure criteria. I will create one failure criteria. So I have applied some material properties which are available, like I'll say here in engineering data, I have applied the Puck constant or T psi U constant as well. So what I will do, I will create one T psi U configure. You can configure these things here directly apply. So I have created a failure criteria, which is a T psi U. Now I will go to the here. I can go for the deformation plot. I can apply. So you can see the deformation plot. This is the deformation plot 4.06 directly. Similarly, I can go for the failure. I wanted to understand the failure. So I can create the failure too. You can rename that things. If you want a ply wise, you can go for the ply wise. And what kind of failure criteria you want? I have created second failure criteria based upon the T psi U. Then here, this is the ply wise, and what component of failure criteria you want, inverse factor, margin of safety, or reverse factor. So I'll go with the inverse factor right now, and the solution set. If you did in multiple sets, you can choose that as well, and we will apply these things. Okay, so this is the failure criteria. 1.251 is maximum, where is the red, but you are unable to see here anything because we have extracted with respect to the layer wise. So I'll go to the one layer, automatically it will reflect by that particular layer what is the failure inverse resolve factor. So if I go for the stringer, this layer, you can see this is the inverse resolve factor for that particular layer. Similarly, I can go for the stresses. I'll go to the stress. What component of stress I want? This is S1, S12, S13. It is nothing but this is the one is the fiber direction, 1, 2 is the transfer direction, and 1, 3 is the shear direction. So this thing I want apply wise. I'll apply this thing. I will update. So now I will go to the each ply. I'll go to the stringent ply. What is the stresses we have? So I'll go to this ply. You will see the stress 56 megapascal. Sorry, which at the first stringent ply. Onto the second ply, What is the stress? This is a different, because its orientation is different. Because of that, it's weak in this direction. Applied load direction, because I have applied the load in the x direction. So this is the this is in that direction only. So we are getting very less stress in that particular. But for this first layer, we are getting some 56 megapascal is the maximum stress. So this is the some of the out I'll say some of the post processing. There are multiple post processings you can do in detail wise. You can see the layer thickness wise plot of your stress variation through sampling and all these things. So as an interest of time, I will not go in detail about that. I just wanted to show you just a workflow, how it is going to be we actually do these things. So I hope these things are helpful for you to understand how ANSYS is in ANSYS we can use for the modeling the composites. So with that, I will just wanted to summarize our today's session. So what are the summary of the today's session is like, we can integrate ACP ANSYS composite modeling into the ANSYS workbench. We have very easy modeling technique, which is a ply-based technique, model as a built philosophy. We can model the manufacturing process also. You can create the fast and also you can create certain modifications also. Once you did certain analysis, you can create certain patch, you can create additional layer at that particular layer very easily. And we have all kind of failure criteria available to assess our composite structures. And the post processings are also very easy. So in post processing, we have all the composite theories which are advanced also with respect to which we can discuss the failure of our composite structures. So with that, I hope this is very this was inform this was helpful for you guys to understand the workflow. As an interest of time, I didn't shown you the complete example, but the most of the things are the repetitive in the other bonding left and cover also. We are going to use the same orientation selection set and rosettes for creating the layup. So if you do have any questions, we can take that question